Humans have been augmenting their bodies for thousands of years. But right now, across the world, scientists are working on even more incredible improvements to our bodies.
You can't comprehend the joy that it would give to someone to feel they've got that leg back.
But what could that mean for our future?
One would hope that robotic limbs can be integrated in a human body in a way that they become better than our biological limbs.
In this episode, we're going to discover what our transhuman future could be when we imagine beyond the body.
I always liked my motorbikes, rode them a lot. I used to use my bike to commute, and I had just left my house on Halloween, literally 2 minutes out of the house on the main road. I was minutes from dying on the side of the road. And then it was 22 hours of surgery. They came back after that surgery and said, we have to amputate. Helplessness is the key word. I've got no tools to make this right. I had a mechanical leg, so walking was very, very difficult at the beginning. It was something I didn't think I was going to be able to do. And then eventually, I had the opportunity to get the microprocessor leg, so it has a gyroscope in it, so it continually knows where the leg is in real-time space. I can walk naturally. I don't have to think about my steps. I just move my leg and my foot's there. You can't comprehend the joy that it would give to someone to feel they've got that leg back. The legs give me the opportunity to possibly just be a normal, everyday player. The technology behind it is just incredible.
So in the world of prosthetic engineering, there are a number of exciting pathways.
The leg isn't holding me back, now it's me. Yeah, I can do what I like, I've just got to do it now.
If one look at the future in a bit more futuristic way, one would hope that robotic limbs can be integrated in a human body in a way that they become better than our biological limbs. Then there is all the aspects of neural interfacing, with the nervous system, with the spinal cord, with peripheral nerves. And a third aspect is the computational one. We have a huge computational power now. We can build artificial neural networks that are orders of magnitude superior with respect to the past. And with this, we can extract really a lot of information from the nervous system. Is it actually possible for a brain like ours, who has evolved for millions of years with a certain body, to adapt to an extra part of the body? Is it possible to represent that part? Is it possible to control that part? The ultimate goal would be the Star Wars example, in which Luke Skywalker had an end amputated and he has the end substituted in 24 hours in a way that is indistinguishable from a biological limb. It's an easy to state goal, but it's very, very difficult to reach, and the challenges are enormous.